Welcome to today's Escape to the Country. Now, this little beauty is the Devon Belle. Over 70 years ago, she was one of 933 boats that took part in Operation Dynamo, one of the most daring rescue operations in history. Now, she leads an altogether much quieter life. But find out where in just a minute.
Today, we're helping a young couple wave goodbye to urban living and find their perfect rural pad. Could a cosy cottage steal their hearts?
Beautiful.
So pretty.
Or will a stylish interior give another house the edge?
Oh, wow. It's definitely right up our street.
Yeah.
Well, today we're in Berkshire on the River Thames, where the Devon Belle takes day trippers on pleasure trips up and down the river. But back in 1940, this little craft found herself in the heat of battle. She was one of the little ships of Dunkirk, playing her role in helping to rescue some 338,000 Allied troops from the beaches of Dunkirk. Later on in the show, we'll be taking a lovely little cruise on her down the river, finding out a bit more about her history and tales from the riverbank. At £387,000, your average attached property is, wait for it, a whopping £133,000 above the national figure. This is a county where you do need your pockets to be that little bit deeper. So let's catch up with today's buyers and see if they really know what they've let themselves in for.
Kim and Chara lived in London before moving to Guildford 7 years ago. But with the birth of their son last year, they feel it's time for a change.
I would have always seen myself as a city person, and I really enjoy the city. Most of our holidays that Kim and I have been on pre-Milo were cities. But now I think with him coming along, we enjoy doing things together as a family. There's a whole new chapter just about to unravel itself, and we'd quite like to do that in the country.
Chara's job as a pharmaceutical executive is relocating from London to Newbury, and with wedding planner Kim running her business from home, it seemed like the right time to up sticks and follow their dream.
We are basically looking for somewhere within a commutable distance of Newbury, so we've got quite a wide search area, but we'd like somewhere that's got a real sense of community.
I really enjoy sports, golf particularly, so actually a nice golf course nearby wouldn't hurt either, and a good pub of course.
Yes, absolutely.
At the moment, home is a modern house on a new development, but they're itching for a change.
We'd like something different. We'd like a period property. We'd like the idea of a roaring fire or a wood burner and just that more rustic look. We're open to doing a bit of work, but not masses. We don't have the best DIY skills, do we?
No.
With plans for more children in the future, Kim and Chara are looking for more space. But what will really sell this new rural home to both of them?
I think for me, the one room that's going to draw me to a house is the kitchen. I love cooking and baking, and so for me that's kind of the heart of the home, and I spend a lot of time in there.
For me, a nice lounge that's big enough to hold a 50-inch flat screen, even though Kim's not too keen on it. But I'm a bit of a sports fanatic, so it'd be quite nice to sit down on a Sunday with a beer in hand and watch TV in a nice warm room.
And how much do they have to spend?
The budget for the move would be £450,000, but we could possibly stretch if we found our dream home.
Our buyers want to be within 25 miles of Chara's new office in Newbury, near the southern border of Berkshire. I'm meeting up with them to find out the details of the kind of property they have in mind.
Well, hello, chaps.
Hello.
How are we?
Good, thank you.
You've picked a nice spot for our little meeting, haven't you?
It's lovely, isn't it?
So the kind of property you're after, let's start with bedrooms.
Ideally four, but three would be okay.
And in terms of space, I mean, you know, everybody wants the big kitchen diner, yeah. And I suppose you are no exception.
No, I think that would be really nice.
Have you got any views on style?
We're quite open, really, aren't we? We'd quite like something with a bit of character. Mm-hmm. We're in a fairly new house now, so it'd be nice to do something a bit different.
An outside space. I mean, you know, some people come on this show wanting the good life. They want goats and chickens and pigs. Is that you?
We're not one of those. I think a fairly low maintenance garden would be absolutely fine with me.
With a football with the two boys, but nothing too strenuous.
So the budget that you have, let's just talk about
the broad figures?
Ideally about 450,000, but we could stretch to about 475 if it was absolutely perfect.
Now, Berkshire, you do, I suspect, have some idea of just how expensive.
Yes, we thought Surrey was expensive until we started looking around here.
Now, I presume you have, like most people, kind of grazed the internet and dipped your toe in the water to see what's out there.
Yes, not a lot.
And hence you're here.
Absolutely.
Hoping for a bit of
magic.
A bit of escape to the country magic.
Yeah.
Well, we are, I suppose, fortunate in that your 25-mile radius or so to Newbury that you've stated as being important, I can totally understand why. It does allow us to border hop a bit, you know, between not just Berkshire, but also Wiltshire and maybe even Hampshire. Mm-hmm. How would you feel about that? Are you wedded to any one of those counties?
No, not particularly. We're quite flexible on the area as well. We don't know this part of the world that well. So it's just finding the right spot, really.
Let's go and see what we found you. Come on.
So with a maximum budget of £475,000, Kim and Chara are looking for a family home with character. They'd like 3 to 4 bedrooms, a spacious kitchen diner and a low-maintenance garden. The property must also be within 25 miles of Newbury, where Chara will be working. We've found 3 distinctive properties to show Kim and Chara, and each one I'll be asking them to guess the price before I reveal it. The final offering is our mystery house, which I'm hoping could just steal the show. So it's time to get started and head for our first property.
You are quite young. Do you not want to be amongst the bright lights?
Well, we've kind of done that. We've been together for a long time, nearly 12 years now.
Wow.
And we started off living in London, and then we've moved out to Guildford, and now we've kind of started our family. We quite like the idea of a bit of a less busy lifestyle, really.
And what are you most looking forward to, this whole new endeavour?
Being able to do more at home in terms of cooking and entertaining and learning about things like gardening and growing veg and things. I know it sounds really cliched.
I think Chara's just got his eyes set on a bigger golf course.
A bigger golf course would be perfect.
Now, Chara said he wanted to be near Newbury, where he'll be working. And the first house I want to show them is just on the outskirts of the town, surrounded by open fields. With the pretty Avon and Kennet Canal running through it, the historic market town of Newbury has all the facilities a young family would need, while the leafy rural neighbourhood offers a peaceful setting. And there's an added bonus for Chara.
I know, Chara, that golf is your thing. There is the bottom end of Newbury Racecourse.
Wow.
Fantastic.
And just the other side of it, see that flag? That, I'm told, is the 16th hole.
Wow.
Perfect.
How about that? And in terms of location, I mean, you know,
walk to work.
I could probably cycle into work,
You could certainly cycle to work. In fact, there's a lovely little canal that runs through there.
Okay. Fantastic.
You could follow that all the way in.
Lovely.
Now, all this is important because property number one is right there.
Wow.
That large bruising thing behind those bushes.
Looks huge.
Very
it is.
Big.
There's quite a lot to see.
Yeah.
So, shall we?
Definitely.
Yes. This way.
Thank you.
Hiding behind the trees just across the lane, this first house is an imposing converted barn.
Come on in. Oh, wow, you said.
Yeah.
Wow.
Amazing.
Wait till you get a proper look at it. There you go.
Oh, it's gorgeous, isn't it?
Beautiful.
So pretty.
It's a whopper, isn't it? Actually?
Yeah, it's huge.
It is huge. Technically, it is a semi.
Okay.
Although as semis go, it's not bad. Obviously, there's a neighbour at that side.
Yeah.
And then behind it as well, there's another building of a similar size attached to it. But you get all of that.
I've only just realised it's a semi, actually.
Yeah.
It's so deceptive.
It's pretty generous.
Space was the key thing, really, and this has got it in abundance. So.
Yeah. But its location to Newbury is why
perfect.
We're here.
Yeah.
Right then, shall we?
Great.
Yeah.
Yes,
yeah.
Can't wait.
Built in 1890, this former agricultural building was transformed into a substantial family home 17 years ago, retaining many of its original features.
Right, let's begin in here.
Wow.
What do you reckon?
Brilliant.
It's a big space.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
That's
really
the joy
space.
Of a barn conversion, I
guess. Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, really high ceilings.
Big, yeah.
Really good family area.
Yeah, brilliant. It's a really good space to work with.
Yeah, well, there's plenty to do. And actually, to this space-wise, I mean, this is great. I mean, quite a fun you know, again, extension of that family area. They've got a huge TV in here, which I know is important.
That was a key requirement.
Get your new telly. Yeah,
exactly. And across here, the hallway, this is a huge room.
Oh, this is gorgeous.
Oh, yes. Love the fireplace.
Yeah, the fireplace is beautiful.
Very cosy room, this. Yeah. They've obviously got it as something of a kind of study as well.
Yeah.
But I think as a snug.
Yeah. It's brilliant.
It's perfect
absolutely
for that. Yeah.
Lovely.
You see this lovely sort of stained glass partition here? Behind it is a spare bedroom, an extra bedroom. One of five.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah.
Wow.
Okay.
So that's where all the space goes.
Yeah, exactly. But I don't think you need five bedrooms.
No, definitely.
In which case, that could also be a study or playroom.
Yeah. It definitely has great potential.
Good. Fine then. Upstairs?
Yeah.
All right. Through there. Follow me.
Kim and Chara seem quite taken with the space on offer here, and there's a shower room and good-sized utility room on the ground floor too. Upstairs, there are three spacious double bedrooms built into the eaves of the barn on one floor, then up a few more steps at the top of the house lies a contemporary family bathroom and an ensuite master.
And then this would be yours.
Oh.
Okay.
I mean, they're in the process of moving out, hence all the boxes.
Yes.
This is a scene I suspect that will be replicated
absolutely,
somewhere soon when you move
drowning
in.
Drowning under them. Oh, it's lovely.
Very nice.
And you get an ensuite shower room.
Oh, brilliant.
Put your heads in there.
Perfect.
Lovely.
This is clearly a house that has the anatomy of a really nice family home.
Yeah, no, it's definitely one that you could grow into and do up over time. There's lots of features that are really, really nice but are almost lost behind everything else.
I like what you're saying. This is good. The creative juices are definitely flowing here. So I suppose the last thing to deal with really is the price.
Yes.
Let's go downstairs.
Okay.
It seems Kim can see past the boxes here and hopefully she'll be inspired by the outside space as well. The large lawn garden is at the front of the property, where there's also a useful double garage.
Okay. So back where we started, now you've had a chance to see what's on the inside.
Yes.
You were quite excited when you first saw the outside. Is that excitement still going on?
I think so, yeah. I mean, it would definitely be a project.
Yeah.
But I think an exciting project. It could be a really beautiful, big family home, I think.
And I think the outside space here, at the moment, is completely underutilised.
Yeah, absolutely.
You could have a lot of fun.
Yeah, definitely.
Let's cut to the chase then. Kim, make me an offer on property number one.
I think it's a lot of house, so I think it's probably £450.
£450.
I'd probably go for £460, just a little bit more, just because of the space, the location.
Well, we are hitting something of a learning curve, chaps, I'm afraid to say, because property number one is on the market for £499,995.
Wow.
Now, I've talked to the owner.
Yeah.
He would consider an offer of £475.
Okay.
Okay.
All right?
Yeah.
Obviously, that's going to soak up all of your budget, so renovations are going to take a little bit of time.
Yeah.
But to be honest, things like painting and that sort of stuff, you can do that.
Yeah, and it's livable with at the moment. You know, it's not...
It's a fair price, I think, isn't it?
Yeah. But that's where we are.
Mm.
It's Berkshire for you.
Yes, absolutely.
Right then, off you go. Go and explore it to your heart's content.
Brilliant. Thank you.
This house is priced at just under £500,000, and although the owner would accept an offer of £475,000, it is at the upper limit of Kim and Chara's budget. However, it has the four bedrooms they wanted and an extra one they could use as a playroom. It also offers the large kitchen diner they were after. And in terms of location, it would mean a short commute for Chara.
The key thing for me was space, and this has got it in abundance, really. I think if you look past a lot of the furniture and everything that is in the house and can actually see through it, it's got everything that we were asking for.
I could see us living here. I think this would be a really beautiful family home. Price-wise, I'm not sure whether we would be able to go to our top budget and then do work, but it's definitely one to think about.
At last!
Yes.
You took your time.
Sorry. There's a lot of house to explore.
Well, it must be working. That's a good sign. Okay, so a nice one to start with.
Yes, definitely.
Two more to see.
Yeah.
Come on. Absolutely.
With Kim and Chara getting their heads round the Berkshire property market, we're taking them to explore one of the county's finest architectural examples. Clifton, near Taplow, hit the headlines in the 1960s as the glamorous backdrop for the notorious affair between the then Minister for War, John Profumo, and model and showgirl Christine Keeler, which ultimately led to the downfall of the then Conservative government. But this architectural gem has a long and illustrious history which precedes the infamous scandal.
Hello, my name's Michael. Welcome to Clifton.
Michael Challoner is the house manager and is taking Kim and Chara on a private tour.
The house was originally built in the 1660s for the second Duke of Buckingham, and it's been owned by many sort of lords and ladies and dukes through the centuries, most notably by the Sutherland family, who were one of the richest families in the country in the mid-1800s.
Surrounded by over 300 acres of glorious grounds, the house was rebuilt by architect Charles Barry in his trademark Italianate style following a fire in 1851. Now owned by the National Trust, it became famous as the ultimate celebrity retreat when it was bought by American millionaire William Waldorf Astor and given to his son Waldorf and wife Nancy in 1906.
There, come through. This is the French dining room.
Wow.
Oh, wow.
And this was installed by the Astors in the sort of early 1900s. They were the hub of New York society in the late 1800s. So when they moved across here, they had massive amounts of money. But to really earn their place in society, they needed a bit more than money. And they did that by inviting all sorts of the top politicians, the royal families from around Europe.
As England's first female MP, Nancy Astor famously debated politics over dinner here with Winston Churchill.
There was many famous conversations that were had at this table, and one of them, she said, Winston, if you were my husband, I'd put poison in your coffee. And he said, Madam, if I was your husband, I would drink it.
If these walls could talk, eh?
If these walls could talk, I'd just love to hear what they could say. It wouldn't all be good, I'm sure.
And it wasn't just in the main house that great figures from history were entertained. Right on the edge of the estate, where the ground sloped down to the Thames, Spring Cottage has played host to royalty.
Oh, wow.
There we are. This is called the Tea Room. The house was originally a little fishing hut on the banks of the River Thames. And then in 1857, it was developed by the Duke and Duchess of Sutherland because Queen Victoria was going to come and visit in that following May. And there was a mad flurry of activity and was really just made into a little cottage by the River Thames, fit for a queen and a duchess to take tea in.
Lovely.
Oozing Gothic style and elegance, the cottage was refurbished and extended by architect George Deavy, who was responsible for a number of properties on the estate. Its balcony overlooking the river was the ideal spot for a bagpiper to warn everyone that the royal barge was approaching.
These wonderfully grand steps, the sole reason they're here is for the two or three times that Queen Victoria came to visit the Duchess of Sutherland. These were built here just so the dainty royal foot wasn't covered in mud each time she came. So what they did was put these magnificent steps in, which lead up over the bridge and up to the cottage.
And why is it called Spring Cottage?
This cottage was built on the banks of the Thames in a lovely rural setting, but it also had a spring. You could just hear it in the background, actually. In the sort of the mid-1800s, there was the gentry liked to get into the rural sort of surroundings of the houses.
Was that the fashion at the time?
It was, yes. They considered this as really slumming it and really sort of going into the depths of the country. Because remember, in those days, it would have taken quite a long time to get from central London to Clifton, so they were a long way out of town.
Yeah.
So really in the depths of the country.
I wouldn't call this slumming it, though.
Having discovered the rich stories of Clifton's colourful past, it's time for Kim and Chara to come back to the present and return to their own house hunt. Our second property is situated 24 miles from Newbury, across the border into Wiltshire, and just outside the large village of Pewsey. Sitting in the rural heart of the county, which is recognised as an area of outstanding natural beauty, it's fantastic walking country. The village itself offers all the essentials, including a good choice of traditional pubs and tea rooms.
Come through the little gate. Now, let's have a seat in the sunshine. Why not?
Why not, eh?
Take the weight off for a moment. There we are. That is property number two.
That is so pretty. A proper little chocolate box.
It's lovely.
Got it.
Oh, wow. What are you expecting?
Probably lots and lots of character. Probably not quite so much space. That's lovely. I can't wait to see what it looks like.
Yeah.
Inside.
Right, come on. Can't sit around here all day.
Go and explore.
This Grade 2 listed classic thatch cottage was built in 1750, although a ground floor extension with a tiled roof was added later.
Squeaky door. Let's start with this. Come on through, Kim.
Oh, wow. That is gorgeous, isn't it?
Yeah?
It's beautiful.
So pretty. I love all the little beams. Oh, it's a proper little cosy cottage, isn't it?
Yeah. I think this is probably more what you were imagining.
I think so, yeah. It's what you kind of imagined to be a little kind of rural hideaway almost.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Completely. Head on that way, mate.
Okay.
Let's carry on.
Another fireplace.
Isn't it lovely? Yeah.
Very nice.
Gorgeous.
It's very light as well.
Yeah, it's really light.
Well, what's nice is that the windows go right through the whole width of the building.
Yeah.
Now, the one thing that I know is important to you, and we certainly had that in Property One in spades, was an enormous kitchen-diner.
Yeah.
This doesn't have an enormous kitchen-diner. Obviously, this is the dining room.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
The kitchen is not massive, but you could join the two together by removing this wall. There's a little hatchway in there at the moment.
And would that be an issue with it being listed?
It's a conversation you'd have with the conservation officer.
Right.
Okay.
And hopefully they would be minded to allow you to do it.
Yeah.
But even as it is,
it's still got a lot of workspace and a lot of cupboards and things.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's fine.
How are we doing so far? I'm going to put you on the spot. Out of 10.
Oh, I think probably about 8.5, 9.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think
I'm at the 9, actually.
Really?
Really, really like
it's really lovely.
What is it about it that's...
It's the character. It's what we had in mind, I think.
I think it's so different because we are in a fairly new house now.
Yeah.
I think that our whole thought of coming to the country and doing something completely different was to have something that had bags of character and charm, and this has just got it in bucket loads.
It seems our buyers are rather taken with the ground floor, which also offers a bathroom and toilet at the back of the property and a large utility room. I hope they like what's on offer upstairs. Off a cosy first floor landing are two charming double bedrooms with exposed beams and sloping ceilings, as well as a modern shower room, along with a spacious master.
This is the main bedroom.
Oh, it's so cute,
it's a lovely room, yeah. Lots of space up here, actually.
Yeah, it's actually a really big room, and nice and light again.
The whole house is, but yeah, this room in particular is lovely, and the views are fantastic as well.
I was a bit worried about the height up here, whether it would be a real deal breaker.
I don't think so.
And any tall friends, we can just leave at the door, can't we? Or leave them outside.
Leave them downstairs and sleep in the lounge.
Brilliant. Well, I'm really, really pleased, actually, because it's a great space. And as you say, probably not what you would have expected looking at it from the outside.
No.
Thatch is always quite deceptive because it's so thick. Doesn't always reveal what the likely size of an upstairs is going to be.
All the rooms are actually quite big sizes, aren't they?
Yeah.
That's good. Lovely.
So about 8.5, 9, you said?
Yeah, I think so.
Still there?
Yeah.
I think 9. Yeah, I'm 9. Sticking to 9, actually. Yeah.
No, 9's okay. Right, let's go out into the garden and finish up.
This characterful 18th century cottage seems to be working its magic on Kim and Chara. It comes with an easy-to-maintain lawn garden, a good-sized driveway and a double garage.
Now, the garden, really sweet, actually. The summer house is rather nice.
Yeah, that's lovely.
Little areas, little zones, and the veg patch over here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Pretty good.
And this is something that you could keep looking pretty all year round. It's not a high-maintenance garden.
No.
What's it going to score on the price, then?
You go first.
I reckon 475.
No, yeah?
See, I think it's more than that. I think it's 495.
495. Well, he's right.
One.
He's right. I mean, obviously, the top of the budget, but...
But so beautiful.
It's ready-made. It's
no
work doing to it, really.
That's the joy of it.
No.
But I think these two properties so far offer you quite an interesting comparison.
So different to each other.
Very different in style and location and finish, but both viable.
Yeah.
We've got some hard decisions to make, haven't we?
You have, and we're not all the way through yet.
I know.
There's still the mystery house to come tomorrow.
Exciting.
Well, go and start the process of thinking and talking in house number 2, and I'll catch up with you a little bit later.
Okay,
thank you.
Off you go. You know, when you look at a house like this, we do often describe them as chocolate box. They are the classic image of English country life, and on a day like this, well, you can't beat them.
On the market for £475,000, This pretty country cottage is right on Chara and Kim's maximum budget. It offers traditional character and charm in spadefuls and is ready to move into. There are three good-sized bedrooms and a low-maintenance garden. What's more, it's just within the all-important 25-mile radius of Newbury for Chara's commute.
I could definitely see myself, Chara and Milo living here. I think it is just so pretty and charming and just exactly what I have dreamt of, really. It's gorgeous. My only downside, as far as I can see, is the fact that it's got three bedrooms rather than four bedrooms. But to be honest with you, I think it's got so many plus points and it's so pretty that I could get over that.
This was definitely what we had in mind as a country cottage. It's just so scenic, it's so beautiful, picturesque. It's a really lovely family house and, it's given us a lot to think about.
Ah, two happy, smiling faces.
Yeah.
A good end to the day, I would suggest.
Yep, very definitely. Good. Pretty end.
A pretty end. But it's a thirsty end too. I think it's time for a beer.
Yes. Definitely.
Come on.
It's the second day of our house hunt in Berkshire and neighbouring counties with Guildford-based couple Kim and Chara. They have a budget of up to £475,000 to spend on a country home. Coming up, there's a surprise in store at our mystery house.
I wouldn't know what to do with it.
Explore it.
Yeah.
And I take a trip up the Thames to discover the colourful history of this Elizabethan stately home.
Now, as you know, on Escape to the Country, we do like to give our buyers as much of a range of properties as possible. And for our final offering, our mystery house, well, no exception is made there. It may well put the proverbial cat among the pigeons. Now, yesterday was interesting, wasn't it? Two very different properties.
Absolutely, yeah. And
have you had a chance to think about them a little more?
We have, yeah. We've done lots of talking,
yeah,
haven't we? And still probably not made a decision, but...
Well, hold off on any decision-making, yeah. Because we'll have a proper debrief later on, but not before we've shown you our final offering, our mystery house.
Yes, it's very exciting.
Very.
Any ideas what it might be?
Not really.
Absolutely no idea whatsoever.
It's the mystery house.
Anything could happen.
Our third and final property is only 13 miles from Chara's new office in Newbury, but it's over the border again, this time into Hampshire, near the small town of Whitchurch. Surrounded by glorious countryside, it's a traditional market town, much of which is designated a conservation area with many listed buildings. There's a good selection of independent shops and a real sense of community, with plenty of local clubs and activities on offer, just what our buyers are after. Now, we're taking a bit of a gamble with our mystery house. Kim and Chara may have asked for a typical low-maintenance garden, but this one is anything but.
There. That is what I want you to look at.
Oh,
how sweet.
Lovely.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
Gorgeous.
It's the flint.
The flint's lovely.
Yeah.
But this one is interesting because, yes, it is a semi-detached. That drain pipe obviously is the middle.
Mm-hmm.
But it's had, back in the 90s, that great big addition put on.
Yes.
The other end.
Side, yeah.
But done very much in keeping with the rest of the property, which is effectively doubled its
footprint. You just can't tell,
no,
can
brilliant.
You?
No,
yeah, it's done really nicely.
Done, yeah. Yeah.
Now, the only real drawback at the moment,
mm-hmm,
is the fact that there is no parking immediately outside of it.
Okay.
Your parking is down that little alleyway,
yep,
and onto the road.
All right.
But apart from that,
uh-huh,
I think this is a really viable option for you.
Lovely.
Brilliant.
Come on then.
This Victorian brick and flint cottage was originally one of a number built for local agricultural workers.
Straight in to this.
Oh, wow. It's definitely right up our street.
Yeah. You see? Lovely, isn't it?
Beautiful. Yeah.
This is very us.
Gosh, it's a big room, isn't it?
Yeah. And can you see that little room through there?
Yes.
Yeah.
Through the doorway. That used to be the kitchen, believe it or not.
Oh, right.
Before the extension was put on. Beautifully dressed now.
Yeah.
And a great Milo.
Perfect. Milo room.
Milo,
yeah,
room,
Milo
isn't
pad.
It?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. And there are double doors off of it into the courtyard, which you can just see through there. It's hard to imagine now, really, how you would fit a kitchen in there. The good news is that it now occupies all of the extension, and it's right through there. Go on,
Kim. Oh, my goodness.
Lead us through.
Oh, gosh, it is huge.
Yeah. What do you think?
It's a lovely size, isn't it?
Yeah, it's really nice. Very light and airy, isn't it? And it doesn't feel like a different part of the house to the older part.
No, it all joins in very nicely.
Really well.
It does go back through that little doorway there.
Okay.
Via a little sort of laundry area.
Okay.
And links up back with the living room.
To the living room.
So the whole thing has a nice circular feel to it.
Yeah, definitely. That's lovely.
I can see us in here, actually.
I think it's really nice.
So far, so good. Upstairs, there are two cosy single rooms, a generous double and a family bathroom, as well as the master bedroom.
Oh, this is a nice room.
Yeah?
Yeah,
it's lovely,
isn't it?
It is the biggest of the four.
Very high ceiling as well, isn't
it?
I thought you might notice that. Yeah. That's what's quite striking about this place.
It kind of makes it feel even bigger, doesn't it?
It does. And, you know, plenty of room for wardrobe and that sort of stuff.
Definitely.
You know, we've got the little box room next door, which could be a Milo.
Yeah.
Or it could be a dressing room.
Yeah.
If you wanted it to be. No, but having four to play with in a property
really
of this size.
Yeah.
Quite unusual.
Definitely.
Excellent. So our mystery house is doing all right.
Yeah, it's very well.
Is it causing something of a rethink on the other properties?
Possibly, yeah.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah, I think it's kind of halfway between the two, if that makes sense.
Well, it has a number of features which I think recommend it, not least outside.
Okay.
Yeah, come and have a look at this. We've got a little surprise for you.
Okay. Right.
I'm really looking forward to seeing Kim and Chara's reaction when I reveal the added bonus this house offers at the back.
So, finally, the garden. It's lovely, isn't it?
It's really
very
pretty,
nice.
Yes, it's lovely.
I think what this place lacks in parking, it makes up for, really, with the garden.
Yeah.
There's a lovely kind of geography to it. Nicely terraced, as you can see, laid out for a bit of alfresco.
Yeah,
you've got the little patch down there as well.
Yeah, that's lovely.
And then down, of course, there, the courtyard.
Yeah.
Nice little sun trap, out the wind. The current owners actually had explored extending that into some sort of garden room.
Yeah, that would be
That's
nice.
A good idea.
Yeah.
So I think, you know, planning permission...
Worth considering,
You know, there is a precedent there for that.
Yes.
But whether you'd need it.
No,
well, that's the thing.
I don't know. Because you also get that. Rather nice garden office.
Yeah.
Fully insulated, wired.
That's really
It's lovely.
Useful
I can see ourselves working in there,
definitely.
Actually.
It would be useful for me.
So, let's have a think about our final price guess of the week.
I think I went last time, didn't I?
Yes.
So it's your turn.
I think this is probably £450.
£450?
I'd say a little bit more. I'd say £460.
£460. Well, you were right last time. But you're right this time.
Ah, there you go.
£450,000.
Wow.
Gosh, it's good, isn't it?
That's good.
Yeah, it shows what you get for hopping over the border.
It does indeed. However, I did promise you a little bit of a surprise. Okay. I think that's a really good price.
Yeah.
But I think it's a fantastic price when you also consider that you also get an acre of woodland. Over
what?
There.
Really? Oh, my goodness.
Okay.
Wow.
A boy's playground.
It would.
Yeah.
Gosh, Milo would love that, wouldn't he?
Wouldn't he just?
I wouldn't know what to do with it.
Explore it.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
But I'm sure I'd find out soon enough.
Well, look, go and explore it.
Yeah.
Wow.
Go and think about what you would do with it.
Yeah.
And I'll catch up with you later.
Brilliant. Okay.
Off you go. Enjoy your woodland walk.
At £450,000, this country cottage is comfortably under budget. It has the spacious kitchen diner and four bedrooms they asked for, and it's an easy commute to Chara's office in Newbury. But best of all, this property brings the countryside right to their back door, as it comes with its own private woodland that our buyers could enjoy with their son.
Look at all the space!
I know.
Especially with Milo being so active.
Yeah, he would love it, wouldn't he?
Yeah.
Build some dens and swings and all sorts in here.
It's just stunning. You could get lost in here, it's so big. From a space perspective, the house is what it is, the lovely house. But for me personally, I think that the woodland is just every boy's dream, really. It's just a great outdoor space.
I love this house. It's got a really nice feel about it, and I think the more time I spend in here, the more time I can see us here. It would just be amazing having all our friends round, and all of their children could easily play in the woods. We could still see them, they could have so much fun, and we could sit and have barbecue on the terrace. So it's just a really lovely, lovely house.
Well, well, well. Mystery house, maybe.
Yeah, that's a surprise.
It surprised you, I think it has. It certainly surprised me, I think, for the money and what's on offer.
Yeah.
Great value, isn't it?
You saved that surprise right.
Well, there's an awful lot going on, I think, in your mind.
Yes, definitely.
Should we go and weigh it all up?
Yes.
Yeah.
Come on. Play.
We've shown Kim and Chara three very different houses in and around Berkshire, but there are plenty more to choose from if you too fancy relocating to the area. You can find characterful two-bedroom cottages with heaps of period features, like this one in Chadleworth, just a few miles from Newbury, on the market for £325,000. While further south, near the Hampshire border in Aldermaston, this three-bedroom Victorian property in the centre of a village is priced at £400,000. If you're seeking more luxury, fantastic barn conversions such as this one in Compton in the north of the county, with a stunning double-height interior and four bedrooms, will cost you £635,000. When we think of the River Thames, most of us picture it flowing through the city of London, but it actually starts in deepest Gloucestershire and winds its way for 215 miles across southern England. Some of its prettiest stretches are here in Berkshire, and I'm taking a trip from Reading, 4 miles upriver, to the Elizabethan Manor House at Maple Durham. My skipper for the day is Tim Deaton, who's telling me more about the boat's history.
The Devon Belle has quite a story to tell, doesn't she?
Yes, she was built in Dartmouth as a passenger boat just before the war, 1938, and she was called up to Operation Dynamo.
This is the moment when the British Army in France can fight no longer and needs rescuing from the beaches of Dunkirk. What was the role of small boats like this?
This would have been a sort of halfway house boat, because it's quite a small boat, it's fairly agile. It could get very close to the beaches, and it would have then ferried people to the destroyers, yeah, and the larger craft which were waiting out at sea. She was kept on by the Admiralty afterwards, and she actually went back to Normandy with the D-Day landings.
Really?
Because she was taken over lock, stock and barrel, painted grey and had a number on the sign. That's about it.
Almost 70 years later, her vital role in the war was remembered when she was invited to take part in the Diamond Jubilee pageant in 2012. And after all she's been through, nowadays chugging up and down this beautiful river seems to suit this little boat just fine.
Well, that is a lovely sight, Tim. Maple Durham House, that's my final destination.
It certainly is, yeah.
Thank you very much for the ride and for the insight into this wonderful craft.
It's been an absolute pleasure.
The splendid 16th century Maple Durham House also has a rich and fascinating history. I'm meeting estate bailiff Corrie Starling.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to see you. This is a wonderful place to end my little trip down the river. First thing that greets you is that wonderful looking mill. What's the story there?
The mill is completely unique now. It's the last commercially working water mill left on the River Thames. We've had a mill here now for over 1,000 years. We go back as far as the Domesday, and it still works.
It still works?
Yep, we still produce flour. We have a wooden water wheel as well, which is unusual. There's not many mills left that still use a traditional structure wheel. They're usually made of iron, but ours is still an oak frame with elm paddles.
The centrepiece of this 2,000-acre riverside estate is the Manor House, built in 1588. It's still owned by the same family, and they have an intriguing royal tale.
The family, the surname is Blount, and there is a lady by the name of Elizabeth Blount, who was the mistress of Henry VIII. And she gave Henry an illegitimate son.
What a coup for the family if her, albeit illegitimate, son had become king.
Everything would have been completely different. Absolutely. I mean, he was groomed as if he was going to be. He was given a double dukedom at the age of 6. He was the Duke of Somerset and Richmond, which is incredibly unusual. And there was always the possibility that he could become Henry IX. Now, if that happened, there would have been a huge difference for the family, but it never did.
It's a wonderful story though, isn't it?
It is.
And it's really lovely to see a building like this still in the same family,
yeah,
after all those years. Yeah. Well, Corrie, thank you very much for your time.
You're very welcome.
It's been a real treat.
Nice to see you.
Cheers, mate. Now, the thing I love about Kim and Chara is that they have taken each of our properties very much on their own merits. That, trust me, is the way to do it. But have they got a favourite amongst them? Well, here we are at the end.
Yeah.
Three very different houses in three different counties.
Yeah.
But have we managed to find you your new home? Well, it is Escape to the Country, of course. So it would be remiss of us not to show you a beautiful little chocolate box cottage. And that's what we showed you with our lovely little thatch.
Yeah, love that. So pretty. And I think if it was just me, Tara and Milo, then we could live there quite easily. But I think if we want to have more children, then we'd grow out of that quite quickly.
So does that mean that property number two is off of your list?
I think so, unfortunately. As pretty as it was, I think it's just not very practical.
OK. Property number one, right on the edge of Newbury, next to the racecourse and the golf course.
Yeah.
Bit of a project.
It was a project, although it was actually pretty much just cosmetic.
Definitely. I think a lick of paint, and I think that space would be really enhanced, actually. And there's no reason why we'd have to do it straight away. We could just do it over a good few years and then... Yeah.
So, property number one, then, is on your list of contenders?
I think so, yes. Yeah. It's definitely a possibility, isn't it?
OK. Well, then we came to our final property, our mystery house.
It was done beautifully, really lovely. And having that space outside, we didn't think we'd ever get that.
And for £450,000.
Yeah, I mean, hitting the mark on in budget front was such a big thing. It just gives us that little bit of...
Flexibility.
Flexibility, yeah.
So... What next? What's your favourite?
I think we might possibly go back and look at the first one, but we definitely would look again at the third one with a view to maybe making an offer on it.
Best of luck.
Thank you very much.
Thank
and as
you
ever,
very much.
Let us know how you get
we will
on.
We do, yes, definitely. Thank you.
You know, I have to confess, when we set out on this house search, I was a little bit anxious as to whether or not we'd actually get there. Despite their very generous budget of almost £500,000, Kim and Chara were pitching it into one of the most expensive parts of the country. But I'm pleased to say, I think we've got there. We've left them with two really interesting options, both of which they're now going to take a second look at. So fingers crossed for them. But I think it just goes to prove that whatever your budget, you just need to keep a little bit of faith with the good old-fashioned British property market. It can so often leave you spoilt for choice, provided you know where to look.
Kim and Chara did return to the mystery house and made an offer, but I'm sad to report that they lost out to a cash buyer. Their search continues. But if you'd like to escape to the country in Northern Ireland, Scotland, Wales, England, or even further afield to the continent and would like our help, then please apply online at bbc.co.uk/beonashow.
Welcome to today's Escape to the Country. Now, this little beauty is the Devon Belle. Over 70 years ago, she was one of 933 boats that took part in Operation Dynamo, one of the most daring rescue operations in history. Now, she leads an altogether much quieter life. But find out where in just a minute.
Today, we're helping a young couple wave goodbye to urban living and find their perfect rural pad. Could a cosy cottage steal their hearts?
Beautiful.
So pretty.
Or will a stylish interior give another house the edge?
Oh, wow. It's definitely right up our street.
Yeah.
Well, today we're in Berkshire on the River Thames, where the Devon Belle takes day trippers on pleasure trips up and down the river. But back in 1940, this little craft found herself in the heat of battle. She was one of the little ships of Dunkirk, playing her role in helping to rescue some 338,000 Allied troops from the beaches of Dunkirk. Later on in the show, we'll be taking a lovely little cruise on her down the river, finding out a bit more about her history and tales from the riverbank.
At £387,000, your average attached property is, wait for it, a whopping £133,000 above the national figure. This is a county where you do need your pockets to be that little bit deeper. So let's catch up with today's buyers and see if they really know what they've let themselves in for.
Kim and Chara lived in London before moving to Guildford 7 years ago. But with the birth of their son last year, they feel it's time for a change.
I would have always seen myself as a city person, and I really enjoy the city. Most of our holidays that Kim and I have been on pre-Milo were cities. But now I think with him coming along, we enjoy doing things together as a family. There's a whole new chapter just about to unravel itself, and we'd quite like to do that in the country.
Chara's job as a pharmaceutical executive is relocating from London to Newbury, and with wedding planner Kim running her business from home, it seemed like the right time to up sticks and follow their dream.
We are basically looking for somewhere within a commutable distance of Newbury. So we've got quite a wide search area, but we'd like somewhere that's got a real sense of community.
I really enjoy sports, golf particularly. So actually a nice golf course nearby wouldn't hurt either, and a good pub, of course.
Yes, absolutely.
At the moment, home is a modern house on a new development, but they're itching for a change.
We'd like something different. We'd like a period property. We'd like the idea of a roaring fire or a wood burner and just that more rustic look. We're open to doing a bit of work, but not masses. We don't have the best DIY skills, do we?
No.
With plans for more children in the future, Kim and Chara are looking for more space. But what will really sell this new rural home to both of them?
I think for me, the one room that's going to draw me to a house is the kitchen. I love cooking and baking, and so for me that's kind of the heart of the home, and I spend a lot of time in there.
For me, a nice lounge that's big enough to hold a 50-inch flat screen, even though Kim's not too keen on it. But I'm a bit of a sports fanatic, so it'd be quite nice to sit down on a Sunday with a beer in hand and watch TV in a nice warm room.
And how much do they have to spend?
The budget for the move would be £450,000, but we could possibly stretch if we found our dream home.
Our buyers want to be within 25 miles of Chara's new office in Newbury, near the southern border of Berkshire. I'm meeting up with them to find out the details of the kind of property they have in mind.
Well, hello, chaps.
Hello.
How are we?
Good, thank you.
You picked a nice spot for our little meeting, haven't you?
It's lovely, isn't it?
So the kind of property you're after, let's start with bedrooms.
Ideally four, but three would be OK.
And in terms of space, I mean,